Hello Abaqus user, welcome to Abaqus Acumen for quick and sound learning. Today we are going to do very interesting session. We are going to do work on a cyclic symmetry problem. So there are so many structures which are having a cyclic symmetry. So you have seen the plane symmetry, x-axis symmetry, y-axis symmetry or z-axis symmetry. But what if structure is a cyclic symmetry? So that's what actually we'll do. It's the problem which we are going to convert is the same problem which we had done, which is on the Abaqus tutorial, how to apply a rotational body force. So we'll suggest you to go through this video so you'll understand how we have done this problem. So the problem you look, it is actually a cyclic symmetry. So every 45 degree there is a cyclic symmetry, and so you can solve this problem. You just take a quarter symmetry and you can solve it, or you can still it shorten it by using a cyclic symmetry. So there are several structure where actually the geometry is getting cyclically symmetry, and we are going to solve that problem. So let's go to the drawing board first, understand what we are going to do. So this particular tutorial we are going to understand how we can do a cyclic symmetry within Abaqus, and this is mainly we have taken is so many structure, there is a geometrical and a loading cyclic symmetry, so you can use a cyclic symmetry option. Now how you can convert this problem into something like a 45 degree sector, you can cut it and then you can use this special command. You can tie cyclic symmetry, so you can tie this surface with this. So this whole surface has to be tied with this cyclic symmetry surface. So all the rotation and translation displacement, the nodes on this face is getting coupled. So that's where actually it's called a cyclic symmetry, and then you define how much cyclic symmetry model, how much is the nodal diameter, and then you define what is the axis. So this is like a 0.1 and this is 0.2. So you define a two coordinates and you say it's symmetry about n is equal to n, and then you use a in interaction you can use cyclic symmetry. And so cyclic symmetry is nothing but like if you have like this sector, if I draw it, the faces, just let me change the color. So face 1 and face 2 nodal nodes on the face 1 and the face 2 should be connected, it is actually have to be tied translation and rotation, and that's where you can solve this big problem using cyclic symmetry. You can shorten down. So we'll do same problem, the rotational body force example. So the structure is rotating with 750 degrees C. So the if you see our earlier video, you'll understand it. And then you will use the SI units, turn Newton millimeter second, and then regular the steel metal property, and then we'll convert this problem into sector symmetry. Also we'll do one more thing is important in terms of processing. You can even do a sector symmetry, and when you want to do a presentation you can do it as a full model. So you can just go here and then you put like there are 8. So like there are 8, and then you say apply, and still you can show to your customer or anywhere, okay, we have done a full model, and just a part you can just go and do it. So it will be like this. So let's solve this problem quickly and understand how we can do it. So let me set first the working directory. So I'll just set the working directory. So I'll quickly create a part. Just one part is there. So the inner diameter is 25, 0, then 75, 0, and then 150, 0. So I quickly go and then put first circle, then I'll put second circle, then I'll put one more point like 0, 5, 150, -5, and then I'll just connect this to this. I'll just use a auto trim command, and I don't want this thing, so I'll trim it. And then the radial pattern, in case you doesn't see this, then you go to add and select the radial pattern. If you have linear pattern, just go and select the radial pattern, and then I selected that, done, and then I want a 8 number. So that's where actually I created the 8. I'll again use auto trim command to trim down the middle. So let me zoom it, and then I'll just trim this. So I trim everything. I'll put a fillet, 5 mm fillet between the structure. So first we are generating a full structure, and then what we'll do, we'll trim the structure. So that way we'll get a 45 degree sector, and then 45 degree sector will analyze it. So we're done, then we'll drag it by 20. So we had a structure now. Now I can quickly go and create a datum. So we'll go and create a datum using 3 points, or we can take a offset from principal axis also. One thing I'll put is on XZ. I wanted 0, so that I done, and then I'll select for others is a 3 points. So I select my first point, I'll select my second point, and then I'll select the third point. So I created the 2 datum point. Now I quickly trim it. I'll say sail, and then I'll say select this, cut the portion, done. I'll select everything. I'll again go and I'll say this is full, and then I want to trim this, cut. So I cut it, basically I cut it for a sector. Now I can quickly, I don't want this whole part, so I've done it. You see some structure is there, and then I'll select this, and I don't want this, so there is. So we got a sector which is 45 degree. I need to delete one more, so let me delete that. So now we have a sector which is 45 degree. Let's go and put assembly. I'll create the property first. So like density we are putting because rotational body force is there, omega. And then we'll put a plasticity like 210 e power 0.03, and point 0.3 as a Poisson's ratio. I'll create a section solid here, and then we'll quickly assign that section to this. So we created now the part definition. Now we quickly do assembly. One minute, I don't know what happened to this. So let me adjust it. So I'll say create Okay, so we created the instant for this assembly. Now here I'll put two points. So I want to create two reference point. One is already it's there, I think 0, 0. So let me put, this is my first point, and I'll put 0, 0, 0, 20. That is no, that is my, so let me first delete. So I'll put 0, 0. So I created the two points. I may have to delete one. We'll see how to delete that. So it's perfectly all right. We'll see how it is. Anyway, one point it select, not a issue. Now we'll create that. This is important, how to create. So create a two surface first. So anything like you put master, it doesn't matter for tie. So I selected this face as my master one, and then I'll select slave, my other surface as slave. So I created the two slave surface now. Then you create a step which will be static step. We'll put NL geom on and it will be like 0.1. And now this is important. This is important for cyclic symmetry. So you go to interaction, create, you go to initial, and then you say cyclic symmetry standard. Then it will ask surface, and then you select master surface. Sorry. Then it will ask for slave surface. You select the slave surface, and it will ask the first point of symmetry. So I say this is my first point, this is so there are two, so I say okay, and then second point of symmetry. So you selected a point one axis of symmetry, and here you'll put number of sector is 8. So you selected master, you selected a slave, and then you selected the point of axis of symmetry, and then we'll put 8 nodes. So all possible things we had diameter were done. So we created that. Now you go to load, you first put end caster condition at here. So it's like an end caster condition done. And then we'll apply the rotational body force on this part. Select first axis of, and then 0, 0, 1. So you just want a z axis. So this define the z axis, and then you put 750 RPM. We'll put a quick mesh. Sorry, it should be in part, so we'll select advanced front, and then only thing is we'll put a 5. We'll select C3D8R, and then we'll put a quick mesh. So we put a mesh. Now we can do quite a fine mesh possibly here, but it's fine. We are just not interested in stresses, but we are only interested in cyclic symmetry. And then we'll quickly do a data check. We'll check if there is anything pre-processor related issue. If there is no pre-processor related issue, then we'll submit it for run. But by the time just it is pre-processing, so we'll quickly have a look how it looks like. Just a minute. So it's, so we'll submit it for run, and then we'll quickly look into the input file, how the input file looks like. So you go and just check how it looks like, so you'll get an idea. So we have a nodal definition. I use a text pad, you can have notepad, but a text pad is good enough. So I'll assembly, then node set. So here is your master slave definition. Then you have this cyclic symmetry, and then here you put your cyclic symmetry boundary condition associated with that. So let's see it done. So let's check the results. So this is how the results looks like. So it was 37 in the full model. In this, actually it's 34.3. it depends on the mesh, how it's the mesh algorithm. If you have same mesh, then you can solve it, or you can make fine mesh. So that was not objective. So this is how you can do a cyclic symmetry. Now important thing, how to do post processing. You can select mirror pattern, and then here you can put number of your sector, and that way you can start look into a full model. That is also possible. So this was a quick video on the cyclic symmetry. It is very important concepts within the FE finite element modeler. Wherever you see the load is cyclic symmetry, and the geometry cyclic symmetry, go ahead and use this cyclic symmetry concept in that. So thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like us and subscribe us. Thank you. Bye bye.